How to set up fault reset on ATV340, ATV600, ATV900 on graphic display terminal or digital input. Hello, today we will show you three ways to set up fault reset on graphic display terminal and digital input on Ultivar process ATV900. Fault reset can be set up in the exact same way on ATV600, ATV900, and ATV340. First, let's start programming the DI. To begin, we are going to assign the external error to the digital input DI3. Then we are going to use the fault reset function. By default, the fault reset function is assigned to DI4. When an error occurs, the drive detects the error. You can activate the digital input to reset the product. Please note that some errors cannot be cleared using fault reset. Refer to the Programming Manual's Error Code chapter. A second possibility to operate a fault reset is to configure the Stop Reset button of the Graphic Display Terminal. This action will allow the users to operate a fault reset with the Graphic Display Terminal in remote mode. Refer to your product's programming manual to check if this parameter is available, according to the firmware version of your product. The Stop Reset button is always operating in local mode. Stop Key Enable is impacting the remote mode. Set Stop Key Enable to All to enable both the stop function and the fault reset function. The Stop Reset button on the graphic display terminal can be used in both local and remote mode. When an error occurs, the drive detects the error and you can press the Stop Reset button to reset the product. In case of any error that cannot be reset, you can restart the product using a digital input. This is a faster solution than switching the drive off and on. We are then going to assign the product restart to the digital input DI5. When an error occurs, the drive detects the error, and you can activate the digital input to perform a product restart in order to reset the product. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.